Basically, as a wildlife photographer, I've been doing it for, you know, probably about 10 years or so seriously. And just in the last couple of years, I've started to supplement some of the still imagery that I've been taking with video. And so this film here just sort of evolved from, you know, all of these little 30-second clips of wildlife that I'd shot down here. And by putting them together sequentially into some kind of a story.
Rick Andrews will be premiering his film Wednesday night at the Nature Center.
You know, we see a lot of great documentaries from across the globe, but this one's from right here at home. So that's really exciting for people in Lethbridge and the surrounding area in southwest Alberta.
The film explores the great creatures of our city through the seasons of the year. It highlights deer, pelicans, garter snakes, and more.
I think what people are going to like is that they'll recognize things. You know, they'll be able to say, oh, those are, you know, things that they see in their daily lives.
But will they? Curtis Goodman of the Nature Center says that people who say they'd like to see animals need to be okay with waiting.
A lot of times, unless you have fortunate timing, you're not going to see these animals out in their natural state, living life. If you're quiet, if you're patient, and you're willing to open yourself up to everything that's around you, you'll be amazed at what you see here. The river and the river valley itself is a great spot to start your explorations, especially if you want to see wildlife, because the water is what sustains all of us, right? And so naturally animals are going to be drawn to open water.
Goodman says a commitment to spending more time outdoors will surely accelerate your chances of seeing animals.
The most important thing is the frequency of spending time outside. And so if you can commit to even 10 minutes every single day, you'll be amazed at what you see.
How many hours did you have to sit in one spot to get that charge of deer? You know, that kind of thing.
Andrews knows all about waiting in nature. He spent endless hours every day outside in the river valley, waiting for the right moments to capture.
I'm very cognizant about not wanting to disturb wildlife, particularly when they're nesting, particularly when they have young fawns and that kind of thing around. So in those instances, I use remote cameras to collect that footage.
The film will feature a variety of shots, including wide time-lapse shots taken overnight and even underwater shots of snakes. Though Lethbridge does not have a national park, this city provides beautiful opportunities to explore nature.
We typically think we have to go somewhere in order to capture good wildlife images. And I think that that's maybe not quite so true, because you can come down here and also capture some pretty good wildlife images as well.
Lethbridge is located along the Central Flyway, which is a major migration corridor for birds that spend summers in the Arctic and then travel down into South America or parts of Central America to overwinter. And so that would be their winter vacation.
Yeah, we don't have like sexy wolves or bears here in the river valley, but you know, we've got some pretty cool things too.
Lethbridge is uniquely home of species like pelicans and specific snakes that are not easily found in other places of the country. But Andrew says our city, among others, needs to be reminded to share.
We haven't historically been very good at sharing. We typically want to use as much of this land as we possibly can. And I think that sometimes we forget that we need to be able to share that with nature.
Andrew says he's not quite sure where his film will end up, but he's glad to have the first showing here at the Nature Center. And the screening tomorrow is not the only new thing around here. There's a new hands-on approach to teaching kids about engineering starting tomorrow as well. For Bridge City News, I'm Josie Foster.